Last week, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, the Right Honourable Thomas Taewa, expressed displeasure on the rehabilitation of the roads, saying the money which was secured by government for reconstruction was instead being used to patch potholes. According to Chisaka, the ongoing maintenance of the city roads has nothing to do with the 27 roads, as it is being extracted from the 6 billion shillings maintenance fund received from the Uganda Road Fund every quarter.
I know that roads can be done at any cost, because you can decide that let's do a narrow road. That would be a particular costing. You can also decide that let's not do a thick road. That would also be a particular costing.
Chisaka said currently the city prefect has identified over 8,000 square kilometers of potholes that need patching to make the roads more motorable as they wait for a complete overhaul. She explained that the 2023 Roads for Kampala project is expected to kick off in February and last 36 months, just in time for the 2026 elections.
But it can be gone in 6 months, in 1 year. We are building roads to last 15 to 20 years. That's what we have said. That is the expectation of our roads, 15 to 20 years. Those details are in the financing agreement.
The project scope also includes draining works, 22 traffic junctions, and 123 kilometers of non-motorized transport facilities, including commercial vehicle parking spaces, bus depots, 30 public toilets, 6 markets, and 1,600 energy-efficient street lights. In 2021, additional 16.37 kilometers were added to the project after cancellation of the $12 million EcoBus project on the advice of Cabinet.
There is no money given to anybody. Besides, if we are to buy land, we go through the PPDA system, the proper procurement system.
Mpere Chitezi to Chiti Road and Ntinda Kampala Northern Bypass to Old Chira Road Junction were added to the project. Last week, Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago also took to the press and asked Parliament to investigate the misuse of funds meant to construct roads in the city. Lukwago said the budget for the construction of the said roads has been inflated, an act that should not be tolerated. Lukwago said the budget for the construction of the said roads has been inflated, an act that should not be tolerated. He alleged that each kilometer was to cost 14.4 billion shillings, which is too high and is bound to hold back completion of the project. However, Chisaka justified the cost, saying it matched the quality and life of the roads to be constructed and was approved by all stakeholders, ranging from the government to funders of the project.
The law strictly. But are we going to ensure the city is rid of illegal vending? Yes. The government has also said that in every division, we must have two markets, two newly established markets.
Story by Edward Kaiwa and Eddie Sejoba for the news.